Hello everybody and welcome back to Speed Code. Today we are going to be looking at installing the JEDI package. Now you may be wondering, what exactly is the JEDI package? So this is a package of components that allows you to get more customizability and more flexibility in terms of how your components look. What the JEDI package does is it has its own set of components that will look different and that have a bit more customization available. So let's look at how we would go about installing the JEDI package. So the first thing you go to Tools, Get It Package Manager, the third option. Then you must wait for it to finish loading. Okay, and then once it has finished loading, you can search for it in the search bar on the top right. So we're going to search JEDI. After that, we're going to select JEDI Visual Component Library 3.8. So as you can see, the way you know which one to do is we are looking for components, right? So we're going to do the Visual Component Library. Okay, let's click on it, and then you can click on Install. Okay, then you can read through License, and we can click Agree. And then you wait for it to install. So first it's going to download it, then it will extract. You might want to take a coffee break. Yes. And then do you want to keep the JSON export settings? Yes. And you'll see it will continue to install once again. Once that is finished, then it will tell you that the installation is finished. You can click OK, and then you need to open up a new window, which you should see in your task manager for the JCL installer, this one here, which is for the code library, and this is what we're going to install next. So you can then click on Next, and then here you can select which versions you would like to install. So I'm installing for both RAD Studio 11 and 10.3. And then once you have selected the respective ones that you need, you can click Next. And then Next again. And Next again. And then Next again. It will then start to install and compile the code library. And then once that is finished, you can click OK when it tells you that you need to restart to apply the changes, and thereafter you can then close Delphi and reopen it. Okay, now that you have got it open, you can search for the label component, and here you want to find the one that is just TJV label, and I'm going to show you how you can use this label as a pretty cool looking button. So we're going to go to the font property, and I'm just going to change the size from 7 to 18. So now I can see it nicely. Let's center it a bit. Okay, and then we are going to change the caption to click me, just to make it more intuitive. And then we are going to go to the frame property. And what this does is it's going to change the color of the frame. So we're going to make it black to match the text, which gives it a nice little frame around it. And that's quite square looking, so we're going to go to the rounded frame property and up that to 3. So now you can see the edges are a bit more curved and looks a bit better. I'm now going to add spaces before and after the caption, just so that there's a bit of spacing between the text as well as the frame. And now I'm searching for the color component, and this will allow you to select a color. So it's like a color picker. There you can see it's called the color button. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger so we can see it nicely. And now I'm going to then create an on-click event. So now when we change the color, then we are going to change the color of the form, or the form's font color. to whatever color is selected. So all the text on the form will change to this new color. So you go form1.font.color must equal the JV color button's color. So now when you run the program, if we change the color to, let's say, a light blue, like an aqua, you can see it changes the text. If we change it to a pink, it changes the text to pink. You can also click on other and then define custom colors, and you can make your own color. So I'm going to make a nice red for the Delphi color. And if we click on OK, you can see it changes the text. So that is how you download and install the JEDI component library in Delphi. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you would like to see how I'm using this in my own tournament planner, then click the video on the left. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and keep coding.